Hey guys, here with another mail video. I have no idea if this is going to be its own thing or not. I have like three or four mail videos that I filmed. I just haven't edited them and put them on the internet. So they're going to be like one video. So this one though, I was going to include in the others because I have not been to the post office in about a month. This was actually mailed April 2nd and today's date is like April 19th. Well, it's 12:40 in the morning now, so now it's April 20th, I think. One of those. But, it's a box. It's got stuff inside of it. I don't know what's in there. But this is from S. Scott from Naples, Florida. So I thought I would make this its own video, go back and do the others, upload them another time, or hopefully before this one. I need to get these all sorted out. I've really fallen behind the whole video thing. But I thought I'd open this up, and since it is a box of stuff, make it its own video, just to make it easier for me, easier for you, give me something to actually upload. So let's get started, shall we? Let's get started. So open this up with my trusty Swiss Army knife that I did not get from the Swiss, contrary to popular belief. And let's get this going. It's kind of funny, like, I have not been to the P.O. Box in about a month. Oh, what the heck? Did you send me Revenge of the Fallen Jetfire? Because that's what that is. I haven't been to the P.O. Box in about a month. You sent me Revenge of the Fallen Jetfire. I feel kind of bad because these popped out. And then there's a thing on the here that says, please read me first. And it's like, I know what's in there now. Okay, so let's get to the letter. Greetings from beyond the new J.T. Mitchell A7. It is I, Vacuuminator. Ah, okay. Now I know who you are because S. Scott, it's like, ugh. I just recently found myself in the process of moving and I needed to downsize a bit of my... as my new place is kind of smaller than the one I'm in right now. So I'm getting rid of some stuff in all manner of ways. Selling stuff, sending it to people like you, or all else, just throwing it away. And, well, coming through things I am getting rid of last night, I found a few things I thought you may like. Inside are some figures, a lot of Pokemon cards, and a few odds and ends. If you already have any of the things in this, feel free to give them away, do a contest or something with them. Well, that's all I got to say for now. Until next time, this is Vacuuminator signing off. Thanks, Vac. Vac is actually someone who has come to my live streams for quite a while, back when it was on Blog TV, before that on Ustream. So I know Vac, so it's cool to see these. I feel kind of bad because I do have our Revenge of the Fallen Jetfire. I don't want to give it away because I feel bad. I feel bad doing that to things that people send me.
He is all bundled up.
I may actually finally review Jetfire. I never got around to it before. I don't know why. I actually kind of liked the combined mode of him and Optimus. I think I was one of the few people that actually did like it. I did like the modified form a whole lot more than like the standard one. So there's Jetfire. Is it weird that I'm tempted to get a second Optimus and then have one combined with Jetfire and then one Jetfire on his own with Optimus off to the side? I don't know. I don't know who would really want to have a Jetfire. So I don't know. I like him though. Jetfire is a really fun little figure. Jet mode's kind of kibbly, but that really didn't bother me that much. I thought it was a fun little toy. And I mean, he's a Transformer. That comes with a cane. So it's like, how can you not find that appealing? I know a lot of people are like, that's not appealing, that's dumb. But I'm a strange person. I am. And I have not messed with this guy since the original, well, I said the original, since I got mine in 2007-ish. So I'm like, I don't even remember how to transform it. I honestly don't remember how. So that should be kind of fun. And I remember this becomes a gun for him. I think you push in. I don't remember. I think that falls up. Ah, there we go. So yeah, I haven't dabbled with Jetfire in like, wow, Revenge of the Fallen came out 6 years ago, so it's been about 6 years since I've messed with him. Jetfire's my name. I know. I like him. I don't know what it is. Like, I like Jetfire. I think I'm one of the people that actually do. And so thanks, Vac. I have Jetfire already, but I like it, and I really could see myself displaying two of them. I am seriously tempted to get another Revenge of the Fallen Optimus, or maybe even finally get Buster Prime. I never actually got Buster Prime, just to put him with a Jetfire and have him displayed. So that's awesome. I'm gonna be having We have a shot glass, because I actually do have a shot glass collection. And let's see if I can actually... Here, hang on. Figures that I would actually hit the button to start recording. But yeah, I have a shot glass collection. So that is something. And some of the Lego stuff. So yeah, so I'm going to put it probably right about there. There. So let's put this back on the tripod. And we're back. So it's just easier putting it that way. And we have a Hal Jordan. I think this is the, this might actually be, I think this is like the DC, I know it's like DC Classics, DC UC, DC something, Hal Jordan. It actually does look really nice. The only Hal Jordan figures that I have are from the DC Direct line, so I can kind of get a comparison of which one looks better. I actually kind of like the head sculpt on this one more than the DC Direct, which I'm kind of surprised about. His neck, his head actually has like a, I don't want to say it's riveted, or ratcheted head neck joint, so that's interesting. This guy's actually really cool. You can never have too many Green Lantern figures. That's one thing. It's like, I think I have 3, maybe 4 different Hal Jordans from just different things. The Green Lantern box set, the first DC Direct one, I think it was like the Hard Traveling Heroes, and the Blackest Night exclusive, and then a future DC Direct. It's like, I can always put a Hal Jordan on a desk somewhere all by himself and have the Green Lantern stuff all on their own. So I can do the same thing with this guy. This is actually really, really cool. He's really, really poseable. I can't decide which one I like more. DC Direct, I kind of stick with because they have, I have more figures of them. But I do have some of the classics, and they do go quite well with them. This guy just looks really, really, really neat. And, yeah. Hal Jordan. I'm not sure if this guy originally came with a lantern or not. I really don't know a lot about the DC classics. There are a lot of little bags here. I don't know if there's a lantern inside one of them. I don't think so. Oh, and I forgot. I showed the shot glass collection. I didn't show the actual shot glass. It's a skunk with a little eye. It's kind of 3D. And on the side, it says, "Why be disagreeable when with a little effort you can be a real stinker." So there's that. I like collecting shot glasses. I don't know. And last, but certainly not least, you weren't kidding. Pokemon cards. Lots and lots of Pokemon cards. That, yes, I'm going to go through each one and show what they are. So, if any of you don't want to watch this, I'm going to say thanks for watching now. Thanks for... I'm going to be here for a while showing these off. I don't know how to really prepare myself. But anyway, thanks for watching. For those of you who have mailed me stuff through the time I've had the P.O. Box, I do appreciate it. I do still have the P.O. Box. And Vac... thank you. Jetfire is a cool guy. I'm going to find a place to put him right away. Hal Jordan. I'm probably going to put him... I may put him on my corner shelf there, or maybe on my desk somewhere. I need to find a place for him. I need a place for all the Green Lantern guys. And thanks for watching. So, for those of you who want to see the Pokemon cards he sent me, let's go through them all. Vulpix, Growlithe, Ponyta, Slugma, Houndour, Mankey, Ralts, two of them, Kirilla, Rapidash, and I think Rapidash. It's 1 a.m. I'm going to blame it on 1 a.m. Ninetales. Torchic here. We have another Torchic of Combusken, an Ekans. We have an Arbok. I always liked Cyndaquil. I thought it was adorable. And I just like the fire Pokemon. Guilava.
Charmander.
We have a Charmeleon. Here we have Ahoho. Numel. Here we have Camerupt of Stunky. Sneasel. Puchina. Houndoom. Magnite. Oh, we have unknowns. The N, I think is B, I'm not positive. The K, Granbull, Snubbull, a Pikachu, Magnetic, two Electrics, and they're different. So there's one Electric, and there is two Electric. Flaffy, Mareep, Pachirisu, Shinx, Minum, Voltorb, Jirachi, Abra, Shuppet, Spoink, another Vulpix, two Cyndaquils, Chansey, Noctowl, Hoot Hoot, a Potion and a Pokedex, Vibrava, Rogunk, Mr. Mime, Zubat, Golbat, Espeon, a Nidoran male, Nidoran female, Nidorina, Ekans, another Arbok, Bronzor, Bronzong, Gia, U2, Typhlosion, Gardevoir, Phoebus, Trapinch, Magikarp, Staryu, Poliwag, Horsey, Bagon, Squirtle, Squirtle, Swablu, Tentacool, Corsola, Sfeel, Barboach, Finneon, Krabby, Lovedisc, Psyduck, Shellos, Ditto, that's turning into a Squirtle, Delibird, Relicanth, Quillfish, Manaphy, Octillery,
we got a Lapras, we found it.
We have a Wingull, Pelipper, Snorunt, Glalie, Goldeen, a Seeking, Shelder, which I almost dropped, Cloyster, Totodile, Croconaw, we got a Slowpoke, a Slowbro, we have a Glaceon, we got a Seal, we have a Dewgong, Buizel, Floatzel, Palkia, and there's a second one, Lotad, Lombre. I admit, I always hated this one. Ludicolo.
I always hated that one.
Piplup. Prinplup. Empoleon. Mudkip. Marshtomp. Swampert. Whalmer. Wailord. Raichu. Loudred. Whismur. Ampipom. Apom. Altaria. Lickitung. Togetic. And the always adorable Togepi. Porygon 2. Porygon. Spinda, Dark Persian, Meowth, Jigglypuff, Eevee, Dunsparce, Happiny, Ditto from the X Delta species, Doduo, Bidoof, Bunnery, Skitty,
Dunspike 17 minutes,
Glemeow, Bronzor, Zigzagoon, Cleffa, Bagon, Lucario, Riolu, Primeape, we got a Mankey, an Onix, we got a Machoke, Machop,
Sudowoodo!
And then a Bonsly. We have a Seedra, Horsea, Solrock, Hippopotas, Makuhita, Lunatone, Fampi, Meditite, Magby, Magneton, Magnemite, Skarmory, a bunch of energy cards. So let's see. Energy. A bunch of the green energies, or the leaf energies, plant energies, whichever. And then we have a bunch of the fire energies. Are those a bunch of I think it's the fighting type energy, so there are those. This one I don't know, maybe it's steel. I kind of want to say this one's steel, but I honestly don't remember.
Don't sue me.
We have a lightning energy. That I think that's the dark energy. I've never seen a holographic water energy, a holographic energy card of any type. So we have water. Metal energy. So that one's metal. Rainbow energy. I've never heard of that one before. Aeron.
Bulbasaur.
Turtwig. Shroomish. Combi. Almost said Combri. Boodoo. Burmy. A plus power trainer card. Another potion. Leftovers. The Quick Ball. Night Maintenance. We got a Pokeball. A Dusk Ball. Professor Oak's Visit. Mr. Stone's Project. Bebe Search. Don't know who she is. Castaway, that's a holograph. Rival. Professor Rowan. Mom's Kindness. Professor Elm's Training Machine. Warp Point. Switch. A different Warp Point. Energy Switch. Super Scoop Up. Switch. Another energy switch of a different type. Night Pokemon Center. Helix Fossil. A Buffer Piece. A Claw Fossil. A Mysterious Fossil. We got a Berry. We have Water Energies. Out the Wazoo. So there are those. We have Psychic Energies. There. Deoxys. Pikachu. Meditite, I think it's a different from the earlier one. The unknown that I guess is a P, maybe? Prinplup, Piplup, Eevee, Glameow, Quilava, Machop, Hoot Hoot, Torchic, a different Wingull from the earlier one that was a holograph, Bagon, Turtwig, Bulbasaur, Weasel. An unknown that is... I'm going to guess an L. This might be the Z unknown because it has zero for the... So that is all the Pokemon cards that Vac sent me. Again, Vac, thanks for the Jetfire. I will find a great place to put him. And he will be very, very happy on my shelf with a bunch of other stuff that he probably doesn't even care about. The Hal Jordan. This is my first and only, probably, DC Classics Hal Jordan. So that is awesome. I'm going to have to find a place to put him where he'll stand out and be all that he can be in the army of the Green Lanterns. And thank you for all the Pokemon cards. I don't know what I'm going to do with them just yet. Usually I put like pages of all the Pokemon cards in there. That would be a lot of pages. So I'll have to find a place for them in my big book of awesome stuff. So thanks for those of you who watched this whole very, very long video of me going through cards. I hope it wasn't too terribly boring. It probably was. But again, as always, if you want to send me anything in the P.O. Box, you want to send me a letter, you want to send me a postcard, you want to send me a drawing, I don't care, send me anything. My P.O. Box address is in the video description down below, unless YouTube changes things, and it's in the top left. That would make no sense at all. And yeah, that's top left. Heard a weird sound over there. That was weird. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. As always, I always appreciate the things you guys send me, and I will get the other P.O. Box videos edited, uploaded, hopefully before this one. We will see. But anyway, thanks for watching, as always, and have a great day. I will see you around. Take care.